I don't know if we can tell anybody anything these days, Danielle. I mean, it's really, I still keep saying to people, put yourself on your own gold standard or silver. I have a lot of silver, eagles and coins because I want to be off the grid. I want to be off the Treasury and Fed and Wall Street. I want nothing to do with those criminals. Do you know what I mean? As Warren Buffett's, somebody just asked, well, Charles Payne asked me on Fox. He says, what about Wall Street saying, oh, I said, well, Warren Buffett said it best, never ask an insurance salesman if you should buy more insurance. And so, because the Wall Street Journal is saying everything is good in S&P land. I'm going, how would you believe those guys?
Rich Dad Poor Dad author Robert Kiyosaki has reiterated his concerns about the future of the US dollar as the BRICS summit approaches. Kiyosaki predicts the launch of a new currency by the BRICS economic bloc and the de-dollarization efforts of around 41 nations interested in joining the group. The summit is set to take place from August 22nd to 24th in Johannesburg, with South Africa as the host. However, the specific agenda doesn't include discussions about a common BRICS currency, but rather focuses on de-dollarization and using national currencies for trade settlements. Kiyosaki has previously warned about the potential decline of the US dollar, suggesting its demise could coincide with the introduction of a gold-backed currency by the BRICS nations. His latest remarks highlight the upcoming summit's implications for the global financial landscape, while emphasizing the intentions of the BRICS bloc to reduce reliance on the US dollar and explore alternative currency solutions.
Please take a moment to like this video, subscribe to the channel, and don't forget to drop your comment and observations in the comment section below. Thanks and enjoy the video.
BRICS, it's almost three quarters of the world's population have signed on. So there was only the, Brazil, Russia, India, China, South Africa, but the big one is Saudi Arabia and Iran. Now, the reason that's important is they hate America. And if you can get that picture, plus you have the Belt and Road Project, you have most of the world that's not, I'm going to hope you don't get censored with me saying this. But the world that they're going into is a non-Christian world. I'm not being, religious and all this. I'm not being political. I'm saying it's, Muslim, Hindu, Islam, and all this. So this is a very big move, is because the world, who is not white, Anglo-Saxon, Protestant Christian, like Australia, New Zealand, Canada, England, they're joining up against the Western currency called the dollar. And so the BRICS is not if, it's only when. Jim Rickards says it best. It's not if, it's when they switch to gold. That's what they're saying. I agree with him. The US dollar is debt. It's an IOU. So what capitalists like Trump and I do is we borrow money to acquire hard assets like real estate. And with the proceeds, with the cash flow, the positive cash flow from my real estate, I save gold and silver. I don't save dollars. I'm very much a hard asset person. I own oil wells simply because oil is energy and economies run on energy. Recently, 2 months ago, I think Biden or the Treasury took the debt ceiling cap off so they could print more money. As soon as they could do that, stock market took off. This is unsustainable. I mean, this is, like it's compounding debt now. It's accelerating debt. And that's why, as you know, Danielle, I'm a big gold and silver guy. I'm a hard asset person and hard oil. I don't buy much paper. I own gold companies and all, stuff like this. But I don't trust the government. It's that simple. The 1.8 trillion in debt, new debt in 2 months when it took 209 months to acquire the first 1.8 trillion. This is the saddest thing, Daniel, because I've been an advocate for financial education. That's why I wrote Rich Dad Poor Dad. That's why Trump and I travel the world, because we're capitalists, we're not Marxists. But the biggest asset in America today is student loan debt. In other words, America is getting rich, and thanks to Barack Obama from Hawaii, Barack Obama basically let student loan debt loose, and now it's our biggest asset of America. In other words, America is trying to survive on the backs of our college kids. If that's not criminal, I don't know what is. It just feels unconscionable to me. That's what I'm saying. But the reason that capitalists lose and Marxists win, okay, and most academics are Marxists. In 1965, I read this book here, The Communist Manifesto. And I left little sleepy Hawaii, and I went to school in New York City, and I woke up, you know. Everything's not hula lands and flower lays and pineapple. But when I was in school in New York, my economics teacher had me read this book here. And just recently, 39 professors at Arizona State University, I mean, just a few months ago, attacked me because I was on stage with Dennis Prager, my doctor, Dr. Radha Gopalan, who's both an doctor of acupuncture and a cardiac surgeon. Dennis Prager spoke on happiness, and I spoke on wealth. And the 39 professors came after us. So they protested. They threatened students that they would lose their grades if they came to see us. What is our title was health, wealth, and happiness. So Daniela, you know how I am with my mouth. I went on, I put my Marine Corps, you know, I wear my Marine Corps jacket. I stood on stage with this and I said, all you school teachers out there, you should read this book to find out who you are. Well, that just infuriated them. So they came after us even worse.
In 2023, the US stock market displayed impressive growth and the latest GDP figure exceeded expectations. However, Robert Kiyosaki, the author of Rich Dad Poor Dad, warns that this positive outlook might not reflect the underlying reality. He points out that the stock market's rise could be attributed to increased U.S. debt due to the raised debt ceiling under the Biden administration. Kiyosaki's concerns about mounting debt aligned with Fitch Ratings' decision to downgrade the U.S. credit rating from AAA to A+, citing expected fiscal decline, rising government debt, and weakened governance. Kiyosaki's skepticism extends to his advice for investors. He emphasizes the importance of assets like gold, silver, and Bitcoin, which have intrinsic value and act as hedges against inflation. These assets, unlike fiat currencies, have limited supply and have historically served as safe havens during economic uncertainty and geopolitical turmoil. Kiyosaki has also shown interest in the potential of cryptocurrencies, predicting a substantial increase in Bitcoin's value and highlighting its scarcity compared to traditional currencies. The text concludes by pondering whether the BRICS conference could mark a pivotal moment in challenging the dominance of the US dollar. You are invited to share your thoughts on this matter in the comments. For more Daily Dose crypto news, check out these two awesome videos on your screen. Click now and we will see you on the next video.